Hello friends, let's start our first Selenium tutorial. I will provide you the course structure. So first there will be an introduction session. After that we will look for IDE, then WebDriver. After that, advanced WebDriver stuff. Then we will look into the framework. The framework can be keyword driven, hybrid data driven framework, or BDD behavior driven framework. After that, we will learn Maven and Jenkins and a little bit of AWS. So let's start with basic introduction. So first point, whenever we learn Selenium, then it comes into the mind that why only Selenium and not other tool? The reason being, Selenium is open source. So open source means it is freely available, but it also means that the source code is also available. That is, you can access to the code of Selenium, you can modify it as per your convenience. So we can say that it is free and code is accessible. Now the second point is, Selenium is supported on multiple operating systems. So multiple operating systems, that is, you can write your code on Windows, Mac, Linux, etc. Next point is, Selenium supports multiple browsers. That is, you can write your scripts for Chrome, for Firefox, for Safari, Opera, etc. So this is the very good advantage of Selenium, because if we talk about QTP, QTP was limited for browser supports. So the next point is, you can write your code on multiple languages. You can write your code on Python, Java, Ruby, Perl, etc. So this is the diversity of Selenium. You can run your code on multiple OS, you can run your code for multiple browsers, you can use a variety of programming languages. So in next tutorial we will start with IDE, and this lecture will be a short lecture. So in today's lecture, we have seen that Selenium is open source. Selenium supports multiple operating systems. Selenium supports multiple browsers. Selenium supports multiple languages. Thank you so much, guys. You can subscribe the channel for more updates. Thank you, guys.